Today, we'll go over different types of roles in a tech organization. Before we begin, I just want to let you know that different companies have different terms for these roles, but fundamentally, they're actually the same roles, or they're shared, or they're just split in a different way. First, the developers. Usually developers are split into front-end developers that could be called web developers, web engineers, and then the back-end engineers. They can be called server-side engineers or server-side developers. An engineer who can do both are called full-stack developers. Full-stack developers would actually implement from the front-end all the way to the back-end. There are mobile developers who design and engineer specifically for mobile apps like Android and iOS. Then there's the designers. These designers could be graphic designers or UX or UI, or both UX UI designers. The designers will come up with the UI or some kind of design, and they will pass that on to an engineer to develop. Then there are the managing roles. They're usually called PMs, but this can mean multiple things. Sometimes it could mean project managers, product managers, or in some companies, program managers. They have slightly different roles, but sometimes they just combine it into one role as well. For example, in my company, a project manager would look at the day-to-day and manage it between different engineers and make sure they have the right resources to actually continue their work. On the other hand, the product manager are more interested in the business side. They will talk about features and how this is impacting customers, how the customers are reacting, and they will communicate that back to the engineers and request some new feature or some enhancements to the current existing features. In some companies, these two roles are combined into one under just the general PM or project manager role. In some companies, a developer or an engineer might take on this role as a technical program manager. Then there are the DevOps, the infrastructures, the operation managers, and the newly coined terms, SRE, which stands for site reliability engineers. People in these roles manage the deployment and managing the current server nodes that exist for your software. More recently, due to the popularity of cloud, there are now cloud engineer roles, which also does the similar things, but just with a different term. Then there are the network slash security roles. These roles will make sure that the software can go out live, the program, the website, and make sure there's no vulnerabilities. Then there are the database admins. The DBAs will manage all the storage, all the data that the organization maintains. They will do indexing, they will make sure that it's mostly optimized to do fast queries, for example. Then there are the data team. These are the rising folks, machine learning, AI, the data engineers, data scientists, they're so-called, and there's data analysts. They would analyze the current data that is stored in the DB and try to analyze trends, understand and forecast predictions of how your product will act based on your current situation. Last, there are the quality assurance roles, the QAs, the test engineers. Their biggest goal is to make sure that nothing goes wrong in production. And if there are issues, they report it back to developers and try to get issues resolved as soon as possible. These were the basic roles in a tech organization. And some roles might not exist in your organization just yet. It might be because it's the organization that you're in currently is too small that it doesn't actually require that kind of specific role. For example, like sometimes some organizations don't have QAs because the developer has a QA role. Sometimes they might have not even have infra or ops because the engineers also do deployment on top of just developing. You might be in some organization where you have roles that were not even mentioned because your organization is way too big that it has to have dedicated people for specific tasks. It really comes down to what company you're in right now and the current company situation, and they will have different roles depending on their situation and needs. Comment down below what role you are in right now or what role you are interested in. If you like this video, hit that like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.